Alright, how's everyone doing? Welcome to From Z to A, Alphabetical Interviews with Zach Anderson. I am Zach Anderson. Today we're here at White House Productions in Shelton for the 21st edition of Monsters of Acoustic Rock, and I am joined by Lucy Isabel. So, thank you so much for being on the show. Yeah. And now I'm going to ask you the difficult questions as long as they have something to do with the letters of your name.
Cool.
So we'll start with L. When writing songs, do you tend to write lyrics first or the music? Does it vary song to song?
I would say most often I write lyrics first. To a certain degree, I'll usually start off with like a pretty solid chorus or a verse, and then I'll just kind of work from there, going back and forth between lyrics and music.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, when you're getting ready to play a show, what do you tend to do before a set? Do you have any pre-show rituals?
Don't really have rituals, I just get kind of weird. Like, people are like, what's wrong with you? I'm like, nothing's wrong with me. I just don't want to talk to anyone. So there's that.
So I'm glad you're talking to me right now.
Right, yeah, no, for future reference, yes. If any of you encounter me before a show, I'm not mad at you. I'm weird.
All right. Now, how do you go about choosing songs for a set list? Do you plan it out ahead of time? Do you tend to change things on the fly, depending on how people are reacting to certain songs?
I have a pretty structured set list approach. I'll usually, you know, earlier in the day of the show, I'll create a set list. If I'm playing a show where I know a lot of people I know are coming, I will, like, field requests from them. The only time I really kind of do stuff on the fly is if there's, like, a set length question. So, you know, I might have something in my back pocket to tack on at the end if I've got a little time.
Sure. Now, what are your musical goals for the upcoming year? Writing, recording, touring?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'm pretty much perpetually touring, so that's a cool thing. But I am hoping to get together a full-length album. I've been working on writing it intermittently for the last few months, so I'm looking to finish that process and then get into the studio and make that happen whilst touring the country. So.
Excellent. Now, what sparks your ideas for your songs? Where do you draw inspiration from?
Kind of various places. Definitely from, you know, my own life, from circumstances. My most recent EP was actually a song cycle about my grandmother and some of her siblings. It definitely pulls a lot from my own life, but I try to then kind of, you know, make it a little more universal.
So I like to end all my interviews with three interesting or random facts about yourself that many people might not know.
That they might not know. That's an interesting one. I'm the youngest of four kids, and my oldest sibling is 20 years older than me. So that's the kind of interesting part of that. I am Puerto Rican and Irish, not a super common combination.
No.
And I actually only started playing guitar about 5 years ago, 4 or 5 years ago. I taught myself while I was a junior in college. So,
nice.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for being on the show.
Yeah.
If you'd like to check out Lucy, please visit the link below. And now we'll cut to a performance from Lucy Isabel. So thank you, and we'll see you later.
Dancer in Heath, a real Bronx-born dose of truth. She was 26 by the time she turned 14. She didn't play by any rules. She had no time for reckless fools. She had plans, she had dreams. She was swimming up the stream. She the wide-eyed kid, she says that she'll deliver. She's a thriller, and they call her Izzy. She's Izzy the killer. Still swimming up that stream.